All right, Quaquaval, time to earn your keep. I just gotta, let me just snap some pictures. Oh, what is going on there? The Quaquaval line of Pokémon is based on various kinds of birds, mostly of the aquatic variety, with Quaxly and Quaxwell being obviously and heavily inspired by ducks. You can tell a lot about a bird, or really any animal or Pokémon, by looking at the shape of their feet. Pokémon that keep the same shape in their feet throughout their evolutions keep the same niche or position in the food chain as they evolve. Pokémon that change the most through evolution are reducing which resources they use to reduce the amount of competition with their offspring or their pre-evolutions in something called niche partitioning. Like Trapinch is a sedentary ambush predator feeding on smaller Pokémon in deserts, but as it evolves, it changes hunting tactics and prey. Similarly, its feet also change, going from incredibly simple legs that are just good enough for Trapinch's sedentary lifestyle to grasping claws and Flygon to facilitate prey capture while on the wing. Quaxly's feet suggest that this Pokémon is highly aquatic. Quaxly has large, highly webbed feet that are basically the same size as its wings or its body. This large surface area would allow for effective paddling while sitting on top of the water like modern-day dabbling ducks. More terrestrial birds, or bird-like Pokémon, would have little if any webbing, and longer toes with talons to assist in traction over terrain. Look at Doduo and Combusken. The Pokémon's feet must carry them through the landscape, as these are flightless bird Pokémon, or at least they should be, and they must be used for combat and dispatching prey. Like, obviously we would expect a water-type Pokémon like Quaxly to at least be somewhat aquatic, but we can tell that it's evolved to paddle through the water by looking at its feet, instead of some other alternatives like its evolutions. A true transitional form, Quaxwell's feet are also the middle evolution here. They change to a bright yellow coloration and are reduced in size, but keep moderate webbing. These are closer to various gull species, a group of birds that don't spend quite as much time sitting on the water as, say, a duck would, but they are still heavily associated with aquatic environments. With a smaller foot surface area while still maintaining webbing, gulls and Quaxwell have evolved feet to balance out spending time on land and in the water. Quaxwell likely doesn't dabble, which is the feeding strategy of dabbling ducks where they sit on top of the water and they can flip upside down to eat aquatic vegetation. Its feet provide less propulsion and its body is more stretched out and streamlined instead of built for floating like Quaxly. Long legs are usually indicative of birds that spend more time walking around or must use them for hunting, like wild turkeys, egrets, or herons. Moving to a more terrestrial lifestyle may also indicate the strength that Quaxwell has gained after evolving. Usually being on or in small bodies of water means safety for young aquatic birds like ducks and also Pokémon like Quaxly, which might explain why Quaxly is the most aquatic out of this evolutionary line. It may flee to the safety of open water to avoid predators, just like a duckling may flee to open water to avoid terrestrial predators like cats or a fox. Quaxly might be fleeing to open water to avoid Paldea's terrestrial predators like Gumshoe, Spidops, Luxio, or maybe even Meowscarada. Once Quaxly evolves into Quaxwell, it has the strength to battle or the ability to avoid these more land-based predators. Or maybe Quaxwell's diet simply includes more terrestrial plants and animals or Pokémon. Or it could simply be evolving into the ridiculous feet that are on Quaquaval. This Pokémon now has extremely long legs, making walking on terrestrial environments much more efficient, but it also has large flattened toes that provide good surface area for swimming, but also don't impede moving around on the land. And they are incredibly similar to a group of birds known as coots, like this Eurasian coot. Coots have a wide omnivorous diet and often forage in terrestrial and aquatic environments, and I imagine something similar for Quaquaval. These expanded toe pads actually fold up when coots lift their feet, making forward strokes in the water more efficient and walking on land less cumbersome. Coots, along with another group of birds known as rails, will often use their large feet to spread out their weight, allowing them to walk on top of floating vegetation. This may allow Quaquaval the ability to access different habitats it normally wouldn't be able to navigate prior to evolution, or gives them a stealth advantage by ambushing prey from above the water's surface by standing on vegetation, which is great niche partitioning, allowing Quaquaval to use totally different resources than Quaxly and Quaxwell, and allows them to all live in the same environment and general area without worrying about eating each other's food all the time. Realistically, Quaquaval's feet would be much too small to be able to support this 136-pound Pokémon standing on top of floating vegetation, but I can really appreciate what the artist was trying to go after here. I was honestly just on a trip and got this cool footage of the coot feet like up close and in action at a park, and I thought, wow, this would be great for a Pokémon video, but I didn't actually know what I was gonna put it in. So hopefully you enjoyed this hyper-specific video on the ecology and biological implications of Pokemon feet, but also cool footage, so yay.